all kinds of organizations have suddenly started working out God's ways. Like mushrooms, during the rainy season, they suddenly appear. And we really get lost to find out if there is anything truthful when we talk about God, talk about His heavenly power. We even doubt if Christ was great. We doubt ourselves all the time as well. There is no way of finding out whether our scriptures have any meaning or not, because we have also lost something in the modern times. Our sensitivity to spirituality is being completely dumbed, stunned by various kinds of pseudo-efforts by intellectuals, we can say psychologists, spiritualists, and all such people who are entering into the realm of religion and God and trying to propagate their own theories. At this juncture, even today, the situation is such that we get confused even about our own confusion. And at this time, it is my luck to present to you something really sensible. So the task is very tremendous. But we must find out ways and methods to judge even the credibility of a person who talks about God through our reasoning. It is all right to say that it is all beyond reasoning. You have to go with the beyond your thoughts. But even to accept something, we use our rationality. And if you have to do it blindly, then there are many people who are following things absolutely blindly without thinking about it. Both things are equally the same. When you start denying to think about it, to understand it, and do not use your rationality, or you accept something blindly, though going through the way of rationality, we really wander about too much. And because of that, the realization, though it takes place, takes time to its maturity. The rationality can be like this. To begin with, we must understand that we are not yet there where we should be. Why are we still very confused? We have not found out our own meaning, no doubt about it. We are yet seeking, definitely we are seeking. Some experience here and there, somebody said that I met a guru and suddenly I saw a light. That is no experience. So we see a thing clearly, that experience that we talk of has to be related to the experiences described by great saints. It has to tally with many things, even with psychology, even with medicine. In psychology it is described that the evolution has to be now into a new awareness of new dynamism in which you become collectively conscious. In this also there is a very fine line. Somebody came to me the other day, he said that I went somewhere and I felt that I am the ocean, I am the mountain, I am the flower. But I said, how can you be that? Because you have come out of all that, now you are a human being, a higher stage. You are not going to become a frog again, are you? And you are not going to become a flower again. You are going to become something superior. In your awareness, in our evolution, we have evolved not in experience, but in our awareness. In our awareness, we are human beings. But there are many things about which we do not know a word. But we feel that we have to find out something more. There's something else I have to find out. There's an urge within. So you go on saying no to this and no to that. There's a very beautiful Sanskrit couplet saying, yan neti neti vachane nagamo avochas. Where you go on saying, not this, not this, not this. This is one way of approaching, because rationality cannot take you to. So definitely we are not going to become frogs or chickens. Some people think if they become vegetarian, they have evolved. I mean, there are so many vegetarians, even people who think they are fasting have evolved. I mean, there are many people who are dying of starvation. They must be all going to heaven directly, is it? Some people think if they shave their heads, they have evolved. Some people think if they have grown their hair, they will evolve. So we have to go on saying no to this. It is not outside. It is not by doing something outside. So we disqualify all the things which suggest that you wear this kind of a dress, or you change your name, or you dance, jump, sit on your head, or whatever you do. Dress up like this, dress up like that. All such outward expressions are denied. All right. Because by denial only you will start extracting all that is artificial and reality will remain. So that is out of question. You go further where people say that we give you an experience. I mean, now I'm going to the subtler side of it. Now the experience is you are sitting here and suddenly you will find some water pouring onto your head. Or say you will start this thing moving from here to there. Put your rationality into it. What business God has got to move this from here to there? I mean, why is He interested? Haven't you got your hands? Or somebody says that you can fly there. Now you are not going to become birds, are you? Do you want to become birds? Then it's all right. But you are not going to become birds. So that's also cut off. You go further with it, little further with it. People might say that you will get a fragrance. All right, so what? We get the fragrance otherwise also. You go in the shop of fragrance, you can get fragrance. Or somebody says you will get a diamond. So what? You can go to a shop and buy a diamond. Somebody will say that you will see a light. So what? We can see the light as it is. What is there in light? That we can see otherwise. Then somebody might say, I am preparing you for something. But what is the surety? How are you preparing? All those claims are to be on one side. Then some people can give big lectures. They have a capacity to capture your attention. There are greater lecturers we have had and could be much more. Rasputin was one of the greatest orators ever born. So then we come to a point to ask, what should we expect? Well, there are many other things like this. I felt very happy when I went to see that person. If you take little alcohol, you will feel happy. Again you go back to the same verses. So then we come to a point to understand that if it is evolution, it is a living process. When we evolved, our nervous system also developed and grew into a new style of nervous system. Our awareness changed, transformed us. As the psychologists have said that you have to jump into your collective consciousness, we have to jump into our collective consciousness. Means our awareness should become collectively conscious. Now what is collective consciousness? Is to know what kind of dress you are wearing. What is the interest of God in knowing what kind of dress you are wearing? Always put this question. What is the interest of Divine? And then you will reach a point. Or to know how a person sits and talks and how he should hold his knife and forks. Or to know what kind of bottle of beer or whatever you call it he used at the time of properly or not. Or to say that he belongs to a particular culture or that culture and this culture and that he is very much there and he is a gentleman and he is this. Is that the interest of God? It has to be something very much all-pervading, must be common in everyone. Fix up that point. So it must be something within, in every person, every human being. Has to be. Because God is not going to discriminate. It has to be placed somewhere in the human being. Something special, some sort of a special thing must be there for his rebirth. It cannot be outside. And it must be something that is happening by itself, because it is spontaneous, because it is living. We got our evolution through spontaneity. And the whatever evolution has to take place now has to be spontaneous. We have not worked it out. We have not become from. Nobody has changed a monkey into a man, have they, so far? All your medical sciences put together. Even one monkey, or a chimpanzee for their convenience. So it is now a point before us to know that it is not possible for us to do it. If we have to become something else, it has to be a spontaneous thing, sahaja. Sahaja means spontaneous. It has to be something within you, born with you, sahaja, born with you. Just like your nose, eyes, everything, this has to be with you. Now where on the body, anywhere it could be placed. How are we to find out? Through rationality. Let us go to medical science. They say that sacrum bone is called as sacred by Greeks. First they did not know why. But now they say that this bone never burns, even if the whole body burns out. Because it is sacred according to Greeks. And it's such a secure bone, maybe there is something in there. Then also, at that point also, you go subtler, and the negative people will go with you. So you say there is a kundalini. It is written in the shastras, in all the books, everywhere. Even in the Bible it is said that I will appear before you like tongues of flames. And you get subtler and subtler. And they get subtler with you. They say, all right, kundalini, all right, we are masters of kundalini. If you say, we can make you fly, we can also make you fly. But now if you say that it is kundalini, so they say, all right, we are also kundalini, we will awaken the kundalini. How do you awaken the kundalini? What do you know about kundalini? Such big, big books have been written by some people about kundalini. I can tell you, they do not know a word, not a word. They have no idea as to what kundalini is, and they have written such big, big books. Can you imagine this kind of thing going on? Now, when we come to kundalini, we have to know that it is a spontaneous thing, and kundalini is to be awakened, by which you get your second birth, is written in the scriptures. Now, if you have not to believe the scriptures, it's all right. You need not believe them at all. But why not give it a chance? What try? So when you say that we want to try kundalini awakening, you'll find at least 100 masters of kundalini arriving on the screen. Charges are different, styles are different, circuses are different, whole approach is different, advertisement is great, and everybody reaches there for kundalini awakening. In thousands. Greater the circus, greater the crowd. Then they write that kundalini must awaken, and by that you get blisters on the body. Half of them run away. Half of them say, all right, doesn't matter, we'll have even the blisters on the body. And they get it and live with that all their lives. This is not evolution. By evolving you, God is not going to give you blisters. He has some sense there. For blisters, you should not go for kundalini awakening. I mean, you can get them even by rubbing something like a DDT or something. Whatever has to come has to be better. It has to better you. It has to improve you. Evolution means going higher and higher and not lower. This point, you must go on saying and reducing everything. Now, with this idea of kundalini, many other things which are hanging around, like some people think the more you pay, the richer you are, the greater you are for kundalini awakening. There are many who feel, especially developing countries. Those who have got money now, who are affluent, are taken up by another nonsense. And they think that if kundalini has to awaken, they have to indulge into free sex. So Christ is cancelled, everybody else is cancelled, because they never indulged into free sex and they were absolutely against it. So now the new type of kundalini awakening is going to come, by which you are going to become a slave of your lust, slave of your greed, and slave of all these things. If evolution is meant for freedom, you are not going to be enslaved. The power has to come within you by which you stand above all these things and you are the master of everything. Then only it is evolution. That's how we move further on. We cancel this also. That you become the master. You are the master of all these emotions and thoughts and everything. You are above it. These things happen. And people fall into all these, one by one, into some trap or something else. But you have to have a clear-cut idea and understanding that it is your awareness which is to be enlightened. It is easy for people who have read about Kundalini in the books of people who have been realized souls. But it is very unfortunate that such books are very few, out of print, nobody's bothered. But only the fake ones are selling in the market. Very unfortunate, but it's so. So here the Kundalini rises. I say Kundalini can rise. It is awakened. And it can be awakened by you people. All of you can awaken Kundalini. But you have to be a realized soul. It is like what is before the egg or the hen. Somebody has to start it. Somebody has to do it. Say, if I have to do it, what can I do about it? But it's not a crime. If somebody has chosen me to do this job, why must you be angry with me for that? Immediately, as soon as you come to know that somebody is doing it, ego stands up like a big snake and comes up, says, oh, why she, why not me? But then again use your rationality. I am doing so many things at different level. She is not doing all these things. She is doing only this. That is her job. So why should I mind? What is there to be offended in this? She is not going to harm me. If it is going to do good, why not? Somebody has to do. I mean, if you do it well and good, I have said many times, please come. I'll be very happy to sit down there and watch. But you just can't do it unless and until you are realized souls. It's a fact. We have to accept. You see, it would be like a child to say that, why should you nurse me? I will nurse you. All right, nurse. Can you? It's something like that. It's stupid. Not to feel bad about it, in any way. This is one of the big problems I face, that people immediately start feeling very bad and sullen and angry, sitting, who is she? I'm your mother. And I love her. And you have every right to ask anything that you want. I'm here to look after you. What is there to get angry with me? I have to work hard, you don't have to. But remove your temper. The one point I forgot, that you cannot pay for your evolution. How much did you pay to become a man from a chimpanzee? please see your account books. We do not pay for these things. How much did we pay for the air we get, for the light we get, for the sun's rays, for the mother? What have we paid? A simple thing, we cannot pay for love of God. It is in His love He is doing all these things. Only if we are little weak to receive it. Sometimes we have our problems. But to receive it, we have to be ready at least. Then comes the theory behind it. And I say that supposing I have done the cooking, why don't you have it first? Supposing you come in the room and ask me a simple question, Mother, how to put the lights on, and I tell you, press this button. It's sensible. Instead of that, I give you the whole history of electricity, who discovered it, and how this... You say, now will you stop that? Please put on the light. If I know the job, I can put on the light. And then you see for yourself whether it is so or not. We have all these things before you, and you have seen the place of Kundalini. There is a book available which you can read and go through all the theories you want, and there's a big one. If you want, you can read that one also. But just now I would say, let's have the light. All right? Any questions? Any questions? Yes. The problem is, after getting realization, your old habits still try to pull you down, you see. As I would say that we are going by a traffic, all right? And we are worried about the traffic, we are tense about it, we see this. Suddenly we find there's a very nice... route, no traffic problem. But it takes us time to relax, still we are thinking there's traffic, you see. It is in the same way. We have had these habits since long of thinking about everything, analyzing everything. The more you have done it, the worse it is. You will find many people here that you give them a flower. Instead of taking the fragrance of the flower, they will be immediately find out whether you bought it in Chelsea flower or how much you must have paid. They will not even look at the flower. They'll say, from which shop did you buy? You better go to another shop, there's a sale on, and why didn't you go to her? Instead of seeing that this flower is given with this joy to you, they will immediately give you some sort of a big information about their analysis. It's our habit. Anything you do, there's a why she did it, who she did it, all that is going, that's our mind has been like that. Now to stop that mind is also job of Kundalini. She stops, but as you said, for a short time, again you lose it. Now we have many techniques. Yoga also means techniques, kaushalam. In Sahaja Yoga, by which you change the habits of your mind. After some time you will also find that even if you become silent, there is bombardment from both the sides, ideas coming in. But if you learn how to misidentify or not to identify with them, you get rid of them also. Gradually it works out. In your country it has worked out with many. Once it works out, we have many people. There's Christine sitting in front of me. 3 years she was like that. Now she's changed completely. See how this habit goes out, because it grows. It's a living process, like a tree, it grows within us, this silence. But it must be started, isn't it? The seed must sprout to begin with. In some people it goes just like that, in some people it does. Because the more intelligent you are, the more ready. The more you are ready, the worse it is. Because you start analyzing of what to do. How can you analyze? Now please analyze how we became human beings. These things we take for granted. If we could see that realization takes place when the Kundalini rises and it reaches here and you become absolutely silent and the full breeze starts flowing from you. It has happened to you. This you remember very clearly, it has happened and you felt very peaceful. Then again you have so many problems within you where Kundalini goes and supplies again. It is the first flash of the Kundalini which takes you away into that. But now the road is made. The first sprout has started. It is going to work out. But there are certain techniques which you have to follow after surgery, after realization. If you can establish yourself, it can be. And it's a miracle, I tell you, it's a miracle. Because formerly people had to go to the jungles, forest, fight it out, do all kinds of things. And after years and years of complete seclusion, the guru used to accept them and then he would initiate. And still they used to lose it. There are so many cases like that of this kind. Vyasa, for example, the one who has read this in Gita. If you read his birth, Parashar, who was a realized soul and who was going to the Himalayas, he fell for a woman and that's how this Vyasa was born. And then he repented and went away to Himalayas. So it has happened in the many cases where misidentifications come up. But you don't have to go to jungles, you do not have to leave your families, nothing. You have to stay here, get it and you have to work it out. It's a miracle of the miracles. Those who have to go to the bank can go to the banks, you don't have to run away. Except for, I think, graveyard. You cannot go to the graveyard. I've seen people working in the graveyard. Find it very difficult. We have 1 year, John, who came from graveyard, he was in a very big mess. He used to shake and all sorts of things are there. But then he got rid of all that. But a friend of his came to see him about fortnight back. And he was again very badly off. Only a friend came and with him some negativity came in, I think. Something like that are to be avoided. So there is a certain amount of understanding needed. How to grow this tree of awareness. Because even if it has happened, it goes down because of our problems. Because of the problems of the atmosphere where we are. I mean, if you were not problematic, Kundalini would never go down. A simple thing is like that. But there are problems. I have known people, once their Kundalini went up, for a month and never comes down. I have known many like that. But there are problems, say in the liver. In your case it is liver. So the Kundalini goes to the liver, she is looking at it. Doesn't matter. She'll cure the liver and again she'll be back very soon. Alright? There's a problem with your liver. Everybody has individual problems. But for that you should not be afraid. After all, doesn't matter. Even if it is a fifth hand car, I am quite good at repairing. And your Kundalini helps me there. So you need not worry about that. It's alright. But don't feel guilty then. That's the biggest problem. Because as soon as I say that this chakra is catching, immediately people start feeling guilty. Oh God, this chakra is catching now. What have I done? I must have done something. You have done nothing wrong, I said. But there's something gone wrong inside. We'll clear it. By feeling guilty, you also make things very difficult. That's also a little problem with people. We must understand, especially with the Western mind, they are very good at feeling guilty. I don't know for what are they feeling guilty. They are such beautiful people. Those who have to feel guilty are arrogant. Those who don't have to feel guilty are feeling guilty. It's a funny world I am coming from. All right. Any other question? Myself? That's the question. where did I get it? It is so ancient that I can't tell you. It's very ancient, thousands and thousands and thousands. All right? You will know where I got it, when you will know me better. All right? Just now, for the time being, just think that I'm really antique. That's making all my desires. What other questions are there? You see, when I don't want to answer a question, I play such tricks. You don't mind. Because you will know why I said it. All right? Later on you will know. I never got it from anyone. It's my own. All right? But that shouldn't make any ego to come up anywhere. You know, that's why I don't want to say. It's better to say that I learnt it from you. Everybody seems to be happy. Should we have now our realization? All right. Just put your hands like this towards me. Now the first thing that happens that your thoughts stop as soon as the Kundalini crosses this point in the center. Agya. Can somebody show? No, I'll show you here. Because the thoughts come to you from ego and superego. It rises between the two. And you do not see any thoughts. Like between the two waves you come in. The silence. And when the Kundalini crosses this point of fontanel bone, which we call as talu, where you are getting your baptism, then you feel the throbbing here, and when it breaks, the throbbing stops and you get the cool breeze coming out. That time you also start feeling cool breeze in the hand. This is realization. That cool breeze is coming from your spirit. First time you start feeling the spirit on your central nervous system, on your hands, actually feel it. When this breeze comes in, then when you start feeling others, you can feel their chakras. You can feel your chakras also. And you can know where is the problem is. Once it is stationed here, as I said, it takes time in some people and in some people it works all the time. Then you achieve that state of bliss and joy, in which you just become a sheer instrument, a hollow personality through which the divine power flows and you just see its manifestation. Please close your eyes. Too much of sahasrara, the problem is still. Just let it go, let it go, let it go. That's why rationality, once you stop, you see, just stop at rationality. Do not rationalize it. Whatever I said, just forget it. Let it go. It's a spontaneous process and has to work out spontaneously. Let it go. Just let it go. Just tell yourself, let it go, let it go. Don't think about it for a while. Just let it go. That's what you are here for. क्या हाल आ रहे हैं? थोड़े आ रहे हैं। उठाओ कुंडलिनी ऊपर, प्लीज योर कुंडलिनी सहज योगी शुड रेज देयर कुंडलिनी सहज योगी. आर यू गेटिंग कूल ब्रीज इन द हैंड? आर यू? नो, यू आर गेटिंग गुड. आर यू गेटिंग नाउ सम कूल ब्रीज? नो नॉट येट. John, just see this gentleman. What is it catching? Now, are you getting any cool breeze? Not yet. No. Are you getting cool breeze now, today? Are you now getting it? Good.